dim sum, beautiful bite-sized delicacies that are arguably the most loved of Chinese foods around the world. But for Hong Kongers, dim sum is about so much more than just food. It's the heart of yum cha, drinking nice tea while gathering with friends and family, usually on a Sunday morning.
While instructions on how to yum cha and where to eat the best dim sum are in abundance on the internet, here at Eat Drink Asia, we're going to take a deeper dive on where it's from, where it's going, and how some dim sums, like the giant panda and this giant dai bao, are endangered.
Those who have tried yum cha are probably familiar with dim sum varieties such as hargao shrimp dumplings and siomai dumplings made with pork. Unfortunately, not all types of dim sum get the same top billing on the menu. Today, I'm visiting a veteran restaurateur with 60 years of experience in the business to learn about why some lesser-known forms of dim sum may be on the verge of extinction.
譚老闆啊，我哋而家台前面呢幾個點心咧，而家已經比較少見噶咯喎。尤其是灌湯餃，點解會少見呢一個點心咧？
呢類嘅灌湯餃咧係入傳統嘅，正正式式嘅灌湯餃。新一代嗰啲所謂灌湯餃咧，佢俾個兜就俾啲湯浸住佢嘅，咁啊變成浸湯餃啦。正式灌湯餃咧，佢只餃包住裏邊嘅湯嘅。
咁呢個咧就最考師傅做嘅，
一個浸窿你都會流曬湯嘅，所以好稠密先係做得到呢個灌湯餃出嚟。所以依家人咧就唔係個個可以做得到咯。
咁馬拉糕點解有一啲人就已經唔用呢一個咁黃嘅糖去整啊？
佢黃糖都其次，佢啲有啲簡單㗎嘛，有啲叫做。 化學馬拉糕嘛，我哋叫佢做，求其拆開啲粉嗰啲叫做化學嚟到蒸咗佢，叫做化學馬拉糕啊嘛。我哋牛種嗰啲嘅傳統馬拉糕啊嘛，咩叫做牛種咧？即係發種苦色嘅發酵出嚟做嘅，所以呢個馬拉糕咧同其他好唔同啊。呢個嗱麒麟面嘅，唔係容易蒸得到麒麟面噶啦，麒麟面咧就咁樣啦，一橫一橫嘅，呢個就證明佢係舊式嘅馬拉糕啦。佢有一種。
發酵嘅香味嘅，
同埋個鬆化係完全唔同。係啦，個鬆佢嗰個鬆咧係挺，但係有不失軟熟。係啦，軟熟唔黐牙。係啊，
唔黐牙。
咁點解焗嘅布丁而家都咁少見咧？焗嘅布丁咧，可能咧就係我哋做慣咗，覺得好容易做啦嚇。有啲覺得佢又即係覺得功夫多啊，又要品。
Some of you may wonder why sago custard pudding is on the list, since it doesn't seem like a traditional Chinese dish. But baked sago pudding was actually invented in Hong Kong, and it is a classic example of East meets West in Hong Kong's food culture. Tam said his mentor, Chef Feng Moon, was actually the one who invented sago pudding. It was in the 1930s, before World War II, when Chef Feng was working in the Chinese restaurant section of a high-end inn near Hong Kong's Happy Valley Racecourse. One day, the inn decided to expand the restaurant's menu and hired a Western chef. Chef Feng learned some Western culinary techniques from the new chef. He combined lotus paste, sago and custard, baked it like a bread pudding, and created the dessert for diners at the Chinese restaurant. Today, this timeless dessert is still made and served in the same way at Fengxing Restaurant.
譚老闆啊，如果以前咧想做點心師傅咧，個過程係點㗎？係咪即係就咁同你哋應徵咁就即刻賣貴㗎啦？
唔係噶，做點心咧，多數就後生仔入嚟做啦。初初入由低做起啦，洗下點心盞啊，要由咁樣做起噶。咁啊一路一路做，乜嘢都做下難功夫咯。
咁做幾耐先至可以食，可以學飽下？
即係都視乎你個人嘅個天分咯。 有啲一年半載做到好多嘢嘅，有啲三年咧都做學唔到咩嘢。
做咗好耐啦，我十幾歲做點心啊，我1967年入行啊，初初賣點心噶，唔係俾你做師傅噶，冇學噶。朝頭早起身，即係4點鐘起身咧，就學下包燒賣啊，包乾蒸牛肉啊，冇蝦餃嗰啲汁噶。到7點鐘到啦，6點半鐘個茶水開，你咪賣點心咯。賣到3點零4點鐘，你入去做啲下欄嘢啊、洗下嘢啊、執下嘢咁噶，冇機會俾你包碟學點心噶。到你做咗2-3年啦，佢覺得你 OK 啦，你自己又唔怕跌底啦，咁你先可以慢慢就去學，慢慢去做啊，就咁樣咯。啊，咁咪一做做到依家。
咁譚老闆啊，真係驚唔驚咧？呢啲咁懷舊嘅灌湯餃啊、馬拉糕咧，真係越嚟越少見，會即係冇得食咧？
我諗將來都一個食問題嘅，
係嘛？
真係食問題嘅，真係呢、這個。你呢班師傅老得就老，退休得退休啦，係嘛？咁你後生又冇人跟上嚟啦。我哋呢啲咧叫做著紅褲仔出身，即係咧由低做起嘅，你考佢唔起嘅。將來有將來嘅諗法啦，嚇！佢退休嘅時間就點樣咧？將來諗法啦，睇下點樣啦。
咁你諗住點啊？嗰陣時
健步行步啦。
我哋啊，
做咗好耐啦，做咗好耐啦，
幾十年啦，
幾十年啦。
最細個我都40幾年啦，嗰啲唔好講啦，我都唔識講，我啲前輩嚟嘅，全部都。
Although the future of Fengxing restaurant and its traditional dim sum may not seem so optimistic, there have been a slew of younger dim sum chefs entering the kitchens of the city, thanks to the efforts of industry schools like Chinese Culinary Institute in Hong Kong. 周師傅啊，可唔可以話俾我聽咧？如果入嚟中華廚藝學院咧，想學點心咧，咁個過程係點噶？
課程咧，我哋會由一個最基礎咁樣去學起嘅。一些廚具的運用啊，廚藝最基礎的一個知識啊，咁樣學起嘅，佢會好似一級一級咁樣去學上去啦，咁啊會提升到佢一個喺點心裏邊嗰個技能咁樣。
最簡單第一樣學嘅點心係邊樣
啊？我哋會撈餡料啊，好多時係啦，餡料咧，咁我哋將佢調味啦，跟住會教下佢哋包啊、燒賣啊。咁樣去學起嘅好多時咯。
咁周師傅覺得咧，點解咧啲同學仔咧會選擇嚟中華廚藝學院，唔去啲酒樓嗰度做學徒咧？
我哋學院咧比較有系統性咁樣去教導佢哋啦。咁包括有一啲廚務管理啊、餐飲營運啊、廚藝學習啊，咁啊我哋會比較多元化少少咯。
咁你覺得比起你細個嗰陣時學徒嗰陣時有咩分別啊？
我哋細個學徒咧，一入去咧啲嘢做唔好咧，師傅會趕咗我哋出去做一啲清潔嗰啲咁嘅工作噶。咁但係如果我哋喺度培訓得佢好嘅，一有咁上下技術咧，一出到去埋到位，就唔會俾師傅趕出去。係啦，咁佢已經有個底喺度啊嘛。
咁周師傅點解你會決定嚟做導師，又唔繼續喺廚房嗰度煮啲美味嘅食物俾我哋咧？
我細個嗰陣時咧，學師咧好多時會做得唔好咧，俾師傅趕咗出去嘅。但每一次趕咗出去咧，我都會話同自己講，我第時就唔會好似佢哋咁樣趕啲學生出去啦，咁樣咁啊，會有多少少嘅機會俾佢學到嘅嘢。
With schools like the Institute standardizing the education of dim sum chefs, there is a new wave of chefs and restaurateurs.Hoping to reintroduce the endangered old-school dim sum to a younger generation. One of them is C.K. Poon. After he helped his former restaurant secure its third Michelin star, he took on a new challenge of managing a new restaurant inside a humble housing estate mall, serving dim sum that many young chefs have shied away from making. C.K., what's your take on the endangered dim sum? And how come they're disappearing from our menus?
傳統懷舊的點心啦，啲手工點心點解越嚟越少喺市場上面見到呢？其實就因為很多都係用一啲比較特別啲嘅食材係咩呢？就係內臟啦。咁內臟最難處理就係清洗啦、炮製啦啊，同埋儲存。第二就係成本啦，因為佢個 costing 低，我哋點樣可以賣得好高嘅價錢咧？亦未必可能會做得到，所以變相喺市場上面咧就越嚟越少。 好似見到個豬潤燒賣咁樣咧，睇落去就平平無奇。其實就係清理呢個豬潤，翻到嚟去揀去改一個大豬潤，我哋先可以做到四盒。但係佢擺耐咗咧，或者擺過夜咧，就唔得噶啦。點解咧？佢就會硬身啦。咁個豬潤食落去咧，就會唔好食噶啦。不如我哋就試下我哋個豬潤燒賣啊！呢個就係我哋嘅招牌之一啦。跟住飲埋啖湯喎，呢個湯都好靚喎，新鮮豬。係啊，試下先。好鮮㗎！
Wow, there's like no gaminess or any kind of organ kind of gaminess to it whatsoever. It tastes very sweet. So I'm gonna try this liver now. The texture is bouncy. It has good bite to it. It still has the liver flavor, but then at the same time, it's not overwhelming.The soup and the meatiness of the siu mai underneath actually comes through. And I see some desserts on the table. Actually, some of these I don't get to see a lot anymore, especially the rainbow jelly. I remember seeing that on the carts growing up, but I was never allowed to order that.
呢兩個咧真係我哋嘅兒時味道啦。咩嚟嘅咧？睇到啦，有把遮呢個先啦。呢、這個就是我哋小朋友咧好中意，好中意嘅叫啫喱糖。我哋喺酒樓咧有架嗰啲叫做餐車啊。咁啊，餐車裏邊咧就有個透明嘅玻璃箱圍住佢哋咧，裏面就好多特色嘅甜品嘅。我記得有蛋散啦，有啲啊沙翁啦、蛋撻啦嗰啲咁樣啦。唯獨是我哋小朋友最中意就係呢一個。其實最精彩係呢把遮仔，好有回憶係嘛？咁我哋師傅都好想揾翻呢啲回憶，可以神還原翻出嚟俾大家試一下。呢、這個介紹一下啦，呢、這個就係我哋嘅芝麻卷啦。芝麻卷咧，其實都係一啲比較低成本但係高創作、高水準嘅甜品嚟嘅。點解咧？好多咧出邊都可能會用粉啊咁去開啦。咁但係我哋嘅芝麻卷咧，其實就係用一啲黑芝麻翻嚟炒香咗佢，之後咧師傅咧就會磨，咁變相咧佢好香滑，同埋呢啲咧又係唔可以。過夜㗎，每日新鮮製作，咁啊做完咗個 lunch 咧，咁夜晚師傅而家下晝又開始準備緊今晚嘅芝麻卷啦。
Wow, I mean you can really taste the fresh black sesame flavor. The ones that are like you know from the powder, you can taste the gelatin flavor. So this is like very strong, fragrant, pungent black sesame flavor. All these ingredients are kind of very humble ingredients. I mean you talk about.Red bean, liver, cane sugar, even just normal gelatin jelly desserts. So why would Man Yuen restaurant insist on using humble recipes that you can't really charge a very high price for?
其實呢個就正正我哋個情懷啦，因為呢一個都係陪住我哋成長，由我哋細路仔識食甜品開始，就係由呢一種嘅味道俾到我哋。徐師傅一定大過我添啦，咁師傅都話呢一種感覺都係佢小朋友年代食緊嘅喎，咁樣咁點解我哋唔可以將佢一路承傳落去咧？可能有啲二十零歲啊，啲朋友仔嚟飲茶，佢都未見過喎，呢啲咩嚟㗎？咁我哋可以有個故事話俾佢聽，其實呢啲就好地道我哋香港人嘅甜品，所以我哋就係想一直將呢樣嘢繼續 keep going 帶落去做翻落去。